Tim J, and man, we have a good service for you tonight. You know, this week is Easter week, right? We're prepping for Easter. Sunday is coming, and we're going to have a word from the Lord on Sunday. But guess what? Tonight, we are in for a treat, because guess what I found? While I was looking through our archives, I found something. I found an Easter play from 1997. Yeah, we are in the old building, and we had a production, and you're gonna see people that have been with us for like 20 years tonight. And man, you might even see somebody doing some Easter speeches. We got some baptisms, we got some baby dedications, and of course you're gonna hear a short word from our pastor, Dr. Timothy J. Wilbur Sr. So sit back, relax, and enjoy this oldie but goodie from the vault from 1997, because we're preparing our hearts for Easter, because Sunday is coming.
Amen. Jesus Christ is not in the grave.
Amen.
But he is alive.
Yes, alive.
How do I know that he lives?
Uh-huh.
He lives down in my heart.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
And if
praise
you know
him.
Jesus Christ, he's in your heart.
And all right, all right, all right.
We thank the Lord this evening for the privilege of being able to come before you, bringing some candidates for baptism.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
The Bible says in Matthew chapter 28,
come on now,
verse number 19, 20,
uh-huh,
says, go ye therefore,
come on now,
teach all nations, baptize them,
all right, right.
Yes, sir.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
Uh-huh. Yes,
and lo, I will be with you all,
always,
even to the end of the age.
Uh-huh. Amen.
Yes, sir.
Jesus told his disciples to go out and you make disciples.
That's what he said, brother.
That's what the church is in business for.
Uh-huh.
We're in business not to just save folks,
uh-huh,
but we're in business to make them a disciple.
Uh-huh.
A disciple is a student,
uh-huh,
a follower,
mm-hmm,
of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen.
Just as General Motors is in business,
uh-huh,
to make cars,
uh-huh,
we are in business,
uh-huh,
to make disciples.
Amen.
One of the signs, and signs are very important to God.
Amen.
One of the signs of a disciple,
uh-huh,
is the mark of baptism.
Uh-huh.
Just as back in the days of the ranchers,
uh-huh,
one of the ways that they could tell their cows from somebody else's cows,
uh-huh,
was the brand.
The brand. All right.
Every rancher had a different brand.
Uh-huh.
In the same way, baptism is a brand.
Uh-huh.
Because all over the world, people are getting baptized.
Uh-huh.
But what brand are you getting baptized?
Come on now, make it plain, brother.
Yeah. Jesus said, baptize them in the name of the Father.
Right.
The Son, the Holy Ghost. Baptize them in that brand. Right. That's the brand of God.
Uh-huh.
So we'll come this evening. We don't bring no cows before you, but we bring some born-again believers.
All right.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
And we are going to mark them this evening,
right,
using water,
mm-hmm,
as the symbol. Baptism is a symbol of an outward, visible representation of an invisible reality.
Uh-huh.
What has already happened is they've already been baptized.
All right now, come on, Ralph.
By the Holy Ghost.
By the Holy Ghost.
They were baptized into the body of Christ.
Yes, they were. Amen.
They was buried 2,000 years ago with Jesus Christ.
Come on,
uh-huh.
Make it plain.
They laid down Jesus laid down.
Uh-huh.
When Jesus died on the cross, those that accept Jesus, Jesus took them back to
the grave. All right, yes, he did.
He put them in the grave.
Yeah, he did.
And when Jesus got up, it wasn't only him getting up.
Come on now.
Everybody who accepts Jesus, in God's mind, they got
up. That's true.
Hallelujah. And so we're just showing what God already has done.
All right.
Praise him, praise him.
We're just laying them down in the watery grave of death. And we're bringing them back up and brand new life.
Amen. Amen.
This evening I bring before you four candidates. Baptism. First candidate is Brother Jerome Allen.
Amen.
Amen.
She said she wants to show the world that she believed in Jesus Christ.
Amen.
prayer.
Amen.
Churches, you're dealing with a responsibility
Amen.
That eventually affects the church.
Amen.
When you got newcomers coming into the church, one of the things that pastors and laymen are concerned is what kind of people.
All right, Amen. All right. Praise God.
Are we dealing with saved people or are people just joining up?
Mm-hmm. All right.
And I think that's affected across our land. We have a lot of people sometimes just joining up.
Mm-hmm.
Salvation, like the pastor said, is what this business is all about.
It's all about. Yeah. Yeah.
And if we miss the mark of salvation, we might as well close the door.
Close the door. All right, brother.
And salvation is the whole point of all what's going on right now.
Amen.
Amen.
This day is a symbolic symbol of what we're talking about.
Amen.
Is salvation. If Christ hadn't went to the cross and resurrected,
all right, now.
Then all this would be in vain.
All right.
And I praise the Lord for the people that I've allowed to make contact with in this new Bible's orientation,
right,
new
members' right.
orientation. You know, you can be sincere, but you can be sincerely wrong.
Sincerely wrong. That's right, brother.
And we have a lot of people that are sincere. They're seeking God. But somehow, because of world circumstances and situations in their life, they've missed the mark.
They missed the mark.
So it's important for us Christians to give people the inerrant word of God. And in order to do that, you got to know the word of God.
You got to know the word.
And I didn't play any part in Brother Webb's salvation. However, I was available. It was no power of my own, but the power of God.
Power of God.
God said, seek and you shall find.
Seek and you shall find.
Knock and it shall be opened.
Amen.
And what had happened, Brother Webb was seeking, and he found. God knocked on his heart, and he opened up.
He opened up. Amen.
It says in Revelation 3:20, he said, behold, I stand at the door, and if any man knock, God says, any man, I shall open.
Open up.
And that's what we're here for, folks, is to seek and to save that which is lost.
Yeah.
We're not here for no form or fashion.
Amen.
We're not here to entertain.
Amen.
We're here to save the lost. We want to be a vessel meant for the master's use.
Amen.
All of us in here are broken vessels.
Amen.
You know, God don't take nothing that's new. He takes something that's broken.
Broken up.
Our lives are broken ever since Adam and Eve.
Amen.
And God takes us just as we are.
Just the way we are.
Amen.
Just as we are. So if everyone will stand so we can... Pastor asked me to pray for these people because these people have a rough road ahead.
Yes, they do.
A rough road ahead. You're talking about new converts that have changed from the old life into the new life. And you think Satan ain't mad?
Yes, he is.
Satan is mad, but God's people is glad.
Amen.
The Bible says when one is saved, said that the saints in heaven rejoice before the angels. So I want to say, this is a time of rejoicing.
Yes, it is.
This is a time of rejoicing.
Amen.
Oh, gracious Heavenly Father, coming to thy throne of grace.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, realize that we're nothing, but you're all in all.
You're all in all, Jesus.
Lord, this is a day that we'll celebrate the,
yes, Lord,
the awesome resurrection power,
yes,
of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Yes,
Lord, you came into lives, Lord, that, yes, we may, Lord, have different lives.
Yes, Lord.
Lord,
yes,
I pray, Lord, for thy people right now. I pray, Lord, that you may be manifested in every aspect of their life. Lord, I pray for Jerome Allen, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
As he faced the world each and every day, Lord, that he manifests you through him. Lord, I pray that you bless him, that he may be a blessing to someone else. I pray for Michelle Haley and Cherie Allen and Alvin Webb.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, I pray, Lord, that you not release Satan of all his assignments on these people's lives, but give them the strength to endure. Lord, you send these trials and tribulations into our lives. Not for us to fold, Lord, or to succumb, Lord, but to build us up, Lord, that we may be better Christians. You said in your word, Lord, that we should rejoice in our trials and tribulations, knowing that these trials and tribulations work in patience. James said in his word, Lord, even though we may fall into diverse temptation, Lord, God has given us the strength and power to overcome. And that's through the Holy Spirit of God. Thank you for your people right now. Thank you for all that you've done. Lord, I pray for the remainder of the service, that you continue to walk up and down the aisles and touch people, men, women, boys, and girls' hearts. Thank you, Lord, for Bible Way, because if it wasn't for you, Bible Way wouldn't be here. I thank you for the pastor, Lord, for his submission unto your will.
Yes,
thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank
bless
you,
every family tonight. Rebuke Satan in all his ways. We ask you, Lord, to have preeminence in all the services tonight.
Lord.
In Jesus' precious name we pray.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Scripture reading, Old and New Testament, by Chantel Williams and LaToya.
Amen.
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 I'm reading from the book Psalms 21st. I beseech you that you walk worthy of the calling wherewith you are called.
Amen.
With all lowliness and meekness, with long suffering, forbearing one another in love.
Amen.
Endurance keep the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace.
Mm-hmm. Praise God.
Praise and praise it.
I'll be reading from Psalms 51:10-13. Create in me a clean heart.
Amen.
And renew a right spirit within me.
Mm-hmm.
Cast me out of the way from thy presence.
Mm.
And take not thy Holy Spirit from me.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Restore unto me the joy of thy
Amen.
Spirit.
Amen.
And uphold
Amen.
Me with thy spirit.
Amen.
And I will teach
praise
the transgressors thy way. Mm-hmm. And sinners shall be converted unto thee. Mm-hmm. I have just read you Psalms 51.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
The Lord had a blessing. The Lord had a blessing through the reading and good of his Holy Word.
Amen. Amen.
Oh, her. I am one of the teachers of the primary class, and I'm going to introduce the teachers that are here. There are four of us. We have 30 students, and we just want to give God a hand praise.
Amen.
Children is evidence that God is truly blessing a place.
Amen. Yes, he is.
Amen. Sister Sanders, would you please stand? She's one of our teachers.
Jesus arose. Glad Easter is here. Happy, happy Easter. In this Easter season, God seeks from above to grant us peace and his eternal love. Christmas is sweet, Christ is King.
Thanks that Jesus loved us and for the blood he shed, but thanks, Lord, most of all, amen, that he's no longer dead.
This isn't just a program, nor just a time to sing.
It's more than just a Sunday that comes in on the spoon.
Jesus came to earth like me to live, grow, laugh, and cry, but he never sinned so that he for my sin might die.
Amen.
While Jesus died on Calvary to offer us a whole new life, but he not dead today, he lives to you and I. Might ever be set free.
Showed it to such a few who are all suffering, can't you see? Jesus replied, I bled and died for all only Calvary, but only a few remain true by serving me and worshiping me. These few did sin, I cannot deny, but they repent, and besides, they recognize only Calvary, I died, so as for them, they're justified.
Amen.
Behind me, Satan.
trouble leaving him, and behold, angels came and ministered unto him. It takes the word of God to drive Satan away.
Amen.
Thank you. Good master. Good master. What shall I do to have eternal life?
Why callest me good? There is no good but one that is God. But if there will enter into heaven and keep thy commandments.
Oh, I have done every one of those. What else must I do?
Go and sell everything that you have. Give the money to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. Come and follow me.
Sell everything that me and my father have worked for?
Everything.
Do you want to defend yourself? Do you want to die?
daughter. Well, say something. Don't you know I have the power to release you or crucify you?
He has no power over me. He has me given from above. Amen. Hey,
Thank you.
transgressions, and he was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. And with his stripes, we are healed.
Amen. Amen.
So tonight, what we saw, tonight we saw a display of salt, didn't we?
Mm-hmm.
You know, Jesus said, you are the light of the world. You are the salt of the earth. And I saw some light tonight. I don't know about you, but I saw some light. I saw some salt. I saw something that's going to preserve the community for the next generation. I'm thankful to Almighty God. You know, we live in a world that is without hope, but I saw some hope.
Amen.
And these children keep believing like they believe. We got some hope.
Amen.
Christ is in them. That's our hope. That's the hope of our glory. Amen. Is the resurrection a hope? Or is it hope?
One hope.
It's a hope. It's not a hope. How do I know? Because when Jesus Christ got out of that grave, Thomas said, I'm not going to believe this. As the rose, unless I see some nail prints in his hand, unless I see the spear print in his side, I'm not going to believe. Because there's a lot of folks talking about that on the road.
All right.
I want to know if it's a hoax or did Christ really rise from the grave? If he rose from the grave, that's hope.
Amen.
And Jesus showed up.
All right.
And you know what the evidence was?
Come on now, show it, Jordan.
It's God.
Amen.
All right.
It's God in his hand. That was the evidence.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
Scars in his side. The scars in his feet. And you know, Thomas gave the greatest confession.
Yes, he did.
Peter just confessed that thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. But when you read John 20, Thomas went further than that. Thomas said, my Lord,
my Lord,
and my God.
And my God.
All right.
That's the greatest confession in all of the Bible. Thomas went from doubt to faith. All because he saw the evidence. But you know the greatest blessing Jesus said? He said, blessed are they who have never seen, but they believe.
Come on now.
You're going to get a greater blessing than Tom.
Yeah.
Praise him.
If you just believe what the Word has said
about
the Lord Jesus Christ. I don't know. I'm not going to take for granted that everybody in here is saved.
Come on now. Make it plain, y'all.
Just in case you don't know Jesus Christ. We're going to give you an opportunity.
Come on.
Jesus has already made the step towards you.
Mm-hmm.
Now you need to make a step
towards
him.
Amen.
He have already accepted you.
All right.
Mm-hmm. You're saying, well, I'm pretty bad, but he's not accepted you.
He's already accepted.
You say, I got all these sins in my life. Don't matter.
Don't matter.
He doesn't accept you.
Amen.
See, if you could clean yourself up, then you wouldn't need
him. That's right. Come on, make it plain, brother.
I don't care what problem you got in your life. Jesus said, just
come on.
God. Amen. All right. God wants all of you. And he's going to do the transform.
Right.
Oh, if you don't know Jesus Christ today, pardon your sin, you need to come today and accept him as your personal Savior. Just in case some of you don't have a church home, we're going to give you an opportunity.
Amen.
Will you stand? Will you come at this time to offer up their child, giving their child back to Almighty God.
Amen. Amen.
Now, the biblical precedent for baby dedication is taken out of the book of Luke, where Jesus Christ's mother and father offered him up to Almighty God when Jesus was 8 days old. And what they were saying, Mary and Joseph was making a public declaration that they intend to train Jesus in the ways and in the admonition of the Lord.
Mm-hmm. All right. Yes.
I believe that that's why you have come today. Because see, offering up the baby to Almighty God, that would not save little Cain.
Come on now, make it plain, Rev.
What that's just telling us is that you're going to put this baby in God's hands for the master use. But little Brookhill, one day it's going to have to confess the Lord
right
Jesus
now.
Christ with her own mouth, and she's going to have to believe in her own heart that God has raised Jesus Christ
Amen.
From the dead, and then little Brookhill is going to be saved. You have the greatest responsibility that God has bestowed upon mankind. And it's the responsibility of training a child.
Amen.
You could be the president of the United States. And if you miss training this boy and this girl, you have missed your call.
You missed your call. All right, man.
That's right.
Anything less than being a godly father and a godly mother, you have taken a step back.
Mm-hmm.
That's fine. So I charge you in the presence of God, his holy angel, and his holy people that you train this child in the way and admonition of the Lord. There's one thing I keep in my office, and it says, children learn what they live.
Mm-hmm.
I also say they're going to live what they learn.
That's right.
And it says, if a child lives with criticism, he learns to condemn.
Mm-hmm.
If a child lives with hostility, he learns to fight.
That's right.
If a child lives with ridicule, he learns to be shy.
Yes.
If a child lives with shame, he learns to feel guilty.
Mm-hmm.
If a child lives with tolerance, he learns to be patient. If a child lives with encouragement, he learns confidence.
Mm-hmm.
If a child lives with praise, he learns appreciation. If a child lives with fairness, he learns justice. If a child lives with security, he learns to have faith. If a child lives with approval, he learns to like himself. And if a child lives with acceptance and friendship, learns to find love in the world. What is this baby going to live with? Is this baby going to learn to live in an environment of love or in an environment of hate?
Mm-hmm.
What environment are you going to bring this child up in? Love.
Amen.
Love. Amen.
Amen.
This child will not be an insecure baby. Will not grow up to be an insecure person if they learn love.
That's right.
Amen. They won't get lost out there in the world if
mm-hmm.
they learn love at home. They know where love have come from. It comes from the Lord. They won't have to go out in the world and
come on now, make it plain, Reverend.
And try to find love in all the wrong places.
Mm-hmm.
If they find love at home.
Amen.
Sister Wilbert, I want you to come because I want to charge you. As parents and godparents, it is your job to be the first teachers. Train the child in the way the child should go. Let me ask you this question. Do you dedicate this baby for the master's use? Do you promise to give your child the best that you have learned of the ways and love of your Heavenly Father, so that she may grow into the love and nurture and the admonition of the Lord? Let me have a word of prayer. Will you bow your head with me? Heavenly Father, gracious and merciful, we thank thee that thou hast given these the privilege of parenthood, has blessed this home with this little life. Bless this child, O Lord, with strength of body, soundness of mind, health of soul. Help these parents to keep Christian values, to develop Christian priorities, and to walk in the path committed to faith, truth, justice, righteousness, so that this child may grow towards thee. Grant them patience and wisdom, good judgment, and balance for this demanding task. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, in Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Bless you. Bless you. All right. Amen. Bless you. Bless you. God bless you. Amen. Bless you. Bless you.